How we doing? So welcome to FX Bootcamp, guys. Let me remind you, the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not alert service. I'm not going to make you direct trade recommendations. What I will do is conduct some live fundamental and technical analysis. With some luck, we can put together a profitable trade plan. Please bear in mind that trading heavily leveraged is risky, particularly leveraged 50 to 1 and sometimes more. On occasion, this leverage will work for you. Unfortunately, more times than not, as a novice, it will also work against you. So please do not trade your hard-earned money so you have a track record of success using a broker's demo. I think this time change is going to mess with us a little bit, guys. You know, one, there's not a whole lot of us here. And two, right, it's 5 o'clock in London. So what do we want to do? I'll leave it up to you guys. Do we want to start this time, or do we want to start an hour later, or how do we want to work it for this week? When do the Londoners get it back on track? Good evening, Kevin. Okay, well, what we'll do is we'll start now today, and then from tomorrow we'll start an hour later, and then Kurt can just coach an hour less. Yeah. So that's what we'll do. I'll remind everybody towards the end of my session so that nobody's left out in the cold. Cool. So it looks like Friday was a good trading day. I wasn't in front of the computer, but it looks pretty sweet. It's sort of the big drop we've all been waiting for, huh? Look at some of these daily charts. I don't think it's over. I think we're going for round two here. Ready. I mean, ready. Just sort of waiting for the 4 hour five and continue. Take a look at this daily chart. Take a look at this daily chart for the euro, and for the Aussie. The pound is a little bit different. No, I think we're going to see more. I think we're going to see considerably more. Just looking at this. You know, look at this stuff here. I know we're at these lows, right? And you even got a little bit of previous support there. You can see it very obviously. And the Aussie is sort of around this 105.28. The thing that concerns me about the Aussie is these reversal pivots coming up. But really, these look like this to me. You know? These look like candles that are going to do a little something like that, guys. Off those fives, what do you think? You know, the only question for us, well, now the pound is a little bit different. Let me drag the pound down here. Here's cable. And, you know, here you're at this triple bottom and these previous highs and stuff. But look at where your 35 is there. You see, I could see power lows before trying to continue massively. So I think we've got to be a little bit wary of the pound. Cable's about to make a lower low just because of that 4 hour 5 it's been waiting for. And it might even drop 50 pips here. But sustainable drop on the pound, I might be wrong, but I don't see it in quite the same sort of potential as some of these others. So I think we should start with the euro. I mean, have a look at the euro and try to figure some stuff out here. I'd like to try and get us in these shorts if possible. They're gonna run right now. Just because ultimately what's happened is we've just gone sideways through Asia, waited for the five. All right, so let's go to this weekly, and we'll move our way down from there. Just hide some of the stuff here. Interesting little development here. No? No, not at all. It's right on track. Right on track. Interesting, we just got this weekly stochastic cross. You know, that's not something trivial, isn't it? If going off this weekly chart, what do you think here in terms of price action expectation for the week? What do you think we could see here? Possibly some red followed by some green, huh? You know, kind of red initially off that five, and then maybe it wicks up, you know, kind of wicks up, then finishes something like that. And then the next week, this followed by, how's your uncle? What do you think? Because it's likely that we're going to respect the reverse fib, isn't it? I mean, this is the green zone of the rise, agreed? So do you think it's likely that we're just going to roll right through that? I think that's less likely. What do you think? So I would expect just, you know, we give this level a little bit of credence. That takes us up, freaks some people out, takes us basically up to like 133. You can write that down. And then, you know. And what's it gonna look like on a daily chart? No, the rest of the world did, Alan. It's still 10 o'clock for me here in the States. Yeah, I'll correct it from tomorrow. I'll start an hour later since I'm trading the European session. Right. You see, and what's that gonna look like? What's that weekly gonna look like? What's the way this weekly is gonna look like? So there's something like the, or this daily. Something like this. You know, and then it starts out, it might even penetrate sort of 129.50. Weekly S2 is 29.75. I think we go down, we might even breach the bottom of the weekly pivots, and then we get something like this going on. So that's Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. And then next week we do this. And we get this same formation we had on the bottom here, we get that evening star. And it's going to be conveniently placed. I'm talking like this stuff is, like it's a freaking roadmap. Okay, you know, and that's going to basically be correlate to these highs. And then at that point, I think we go red. That takes us to Tuesday next week. A little bit of green, and then we have sort of resumption of the trend. Two big down days. Pick up the five, a little bit of sort of a rule nine type setup. A little bit of green there initially into pre-London. And then, whoa, oh dear. Something like that. And it's at that point it's on to the early 120s or something. Nothing changed. You're right, Larry, 100%. Nothing changed in Europe. They found a way to get it done this time. They found a way to get it done this time. But I think the world knows that, is that, you know, there's skeletons hanging out there. Hey, Ricky. Yep. Yep, Eric, you're right. And it's, you know, well, 529 billion is quite a substantial sum of money. But I think that people realize that this is systemic of other European countries. It's not really, for my money, it's never really been about Greece. And I don't want to get into a massive fundamental discussion. I mean, it's been about Greece, but it hasn't it? Greece is a symptom of what other people expect for Europe. So that's why I'm thinking, wait until something like Spain or Portugal default or something, then you're in for a big bag. But anyway, so this puts us as today, so Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. So there's 3 weeks worth. Somebody want to take a screenshot for me, please, and we'll see. Let's, for interest's sake, let's just see how we do. Let's see how we do in 3 weeks' time, see if we're even in the ballpark. Okay, cool, thanks, Kevin. All right, so today, ideally, I'd like to see a sort of fake out to the bottom here. Visit something around 3120, 3130, and then fall quite hard. Here's your 4 hour. So we're getting this drop, you know. It went sideways. Oh, sorry, Medhead. I wasn't ignoring your question about the stock market. We're gonna have a look at that. I'm still a bear there. I'm just thinking it's taking its time, but I'm still a bear. So 4 hour. See, I don't think I want to long this, guys. You know what I mean? Even though I think we'd like to do something like this, and then kind of, you know, a little bit of this, followed by a whole bunch of that. Man. The thought of longing this makes me nauseous. You know what I mean? Makes my stomach turn. But that's ultimately what I'm looking for. You know, basically back to these Asia highs. You know, Eric, if it can rise here in the next 2 hours, if it can rise here in the next 2 hours, I think that we can probably sell it. You know, I'd like it just halfway between us and the central, basically. Not sure we're gonna get it. You know, the other thing to look at is just try to just scalp the waves down. This is support. You know, when you look across the screen here, as bearish as this thing is, and don't get me wrong, it's legitimately bearish. Friday was probably the best trading day, it looks like just in hindsight, than it's been in freaking weeks. We had the drop on Friday that we were trying to trade for on Thursday. You know that? A bazooka. I don't think I've ever used that word in my life before, and I don't intend to again. Right, look at this situation here. I mean, this is, or is it not? It's just look at where your daily five is, in perfect position to plunge us through that. Okay. It's, you see, it just, I don't, I think we could drop quite handsomely right from here, but ultimately, all I want is for us just to do this. And I think we could drop 130 pips. 130.18 is M1, and 29.84 is S2. Well, the weekly, Weekly M1 is at 3011 and S2 2975. So basically got daily S2, weekly S2 almost overlapping with each other. And daily M1 and weekly M1 almost overlapping with each other. I think that's going to be a little bit of a magnet. You know, my trade plan is take it from here down here. And then what'll happen is we'll probably do a little something like that, nudge a lower low and come all the way back to where we started from over the next 24 hours. What did you guys talk about? Yeah, I can see 27. I don't know if it's going to happen this week, but I think 27 is pretty conservative. So you're running your 4 hour 5 now. Okay. I mean, all that we can do here. All that we can do here, guys and girls, is put our little circles in place, you know, and do what we do. If it does, now hear me out. If it does something like this, we're just gonna have to be a little more risk averse today, all right? If it does, we also got this hour of dead time. So if it does something like this, kind of red, and then we get green like this, and then you know a little green candle like that, and then it comes up a little bit green, and ultimately gives us a lower high here, you know, another lower high like that relative to this. I'm gonna take that shot because then I think we'll probably just gun it 50 pips to the downside, just boop, and then it'll come back. And there's no reason why we can't capture that, you know, basically take us down to like 130, 40 or something quite quickly. Much like the Aussies doing now, but because of the correlation, I'm not jumping on it. You know, just like the Aussies doing right now on the 15-minute. What I mean by the correlation is I don't think the euro is quite in position, but exactly this. You know, it kind of makes a higher low, but immediately makes a lower high. That's a good continuation sign. Plus the Aussie, I mean, you 105.20 as support and your daily M1, and there's no meat on that bone, really, even though I have it on good authority, we're going considerably lower there. Okay, so this is our trade plan, but we're going to have to be flexible enough to. We're gonna have to be flexible enough to adapt to this thing as it, you know, if it kicks out a more aggressive entry, then that's what we have to do. And I'm gonna put a blue circle there because I don't think it's an automatic long. I think if you want to buy the euro for about, wow, pretty, the better part of 170 pips, there's probably a very good euro long in the vicinity of 129.40 or so. That should take you back to about 130.80 to 131.20. So, probably 200 pips of upside from there. And all it'll be is a retracement back to the daily five, essentially. Okay. So, let's place some alarms in here. Okay, and what the hourly chart, your pivots are going to look like this. You know, something like that is our plan. I don't think we're going to make it all the way back to that weekly central. That seems. I think what we'll do is we'll do this back to that weekly central. Actually, more like this. Okay, so that's the long I'm talking about, but I think that's more like maybe Tuesday afternoon. Okay. How was your weekend, everybody, by the way? Everybody have a pleasant weekend? All right. What did you guys talk about in Asia today? Not sure. Rob sent me a text over the weekend, you know, because South Africa had New Zealand on the ropes in the cricket. So Rob sent me a text message, something to the effect of, the Angels are beating the Giants, it's raining at the cricket, and something else, like all bad things for me. Really hurt my feelings. He's a real meanie, that Rob. Okay. All right, everybody kind of clear on this plan? 3120 to 3140 is our target short zone. That's right, Eric. That is 100% correct. Very much looking forward to that. With option for it to lower high of 31 and fall 50 pips. Sure, Mark, we just covered the euro dollar, and basically I was looking for us to maybe punch a little lower low, come back to around 131.20 to 131.40, and then head down to 129.80 or so. So a little lower low. Back around 131.20 or so, and then down to 29.80. I'm trying to short this for about 140 pips. Sure. It was a little less than 30 seconds, but that's all we've really talked about in the last 30 minutes.